Now, we have several fractions in each of these equations with different denominators. The first one is 1/3 x plus 1/2 y equals negative 1/4. So our denominators are 3, 2, and 4. We need to find the lowest common multiple or lowest common denominator, and that would be 12. The second equation, we have denominators of 6 and 16. A little more difficult to find that one. We'll pause that for a moment. Once I find the LCDs or the LCM, we will multiply each equation by its own LCM, and we will see the fractions magically disappear. So we will use the fraction coefficients in the equations while we're solving for the other variables, so don't think the fractions are gone forever. As you can see, the LCM for these two denominators is 48. So if we multiply the bottom equation by 48, the fractions will disappear once we reduce. You can cross cancel while you're multiplying, or multiply first and then reduce later. I like reducing the fractions afterwards. It seems to be clearer, but we'll see what happens in a minute. Now we're going to reduce the fractions and we'll see them all disappear. Okay, now as you can see, the two equations are fractionless. Now we can work on eliminating either the x term or the y term from either of these equations. So the goal is to have either, when you add them together, 0x or 0y. For me, I'm looking at the x term because I have 4 and 8, 4x and 8x. I think it'll be relatively easy to have the case where it's negative 8x and positive 8x. I could work with the 6 and the 40 and the y terms, but you know what? So I can save potential mistakes or not make them, I'll work with the x terms. I'm going to multiply the top equation by negative 2. And now you'll see that I left the second equation with a positive 8x, and I changed the 4x in the first one to a negative 8x. So now we have negative 8x plus positive 8x, which will be a 0x. So now we solve for our y variable. We divide it by negative 52 because we wanted the y variable to have a 1 for a coefficient. 39 divided by 52, if we simplify that, it becomes negative 3/4. Now I tend to write my negative sign along with the top number. It doesn't really matter, as long as it's out front. Now that negative 3/4 for y needs to be replaced in one of the equations above, and so we can solve for x. So we'll have to go through and work with the equations once again. And this time I will not use the LCD or LCM to get rid of the fractions. We're going to go ahead and use them as they are. As I'm looking at the equations, the first equation seems to be a better choice. I have 1/3, 1/2, 1/4, and then 3/4 for an answer. It seems manageable. Now I could use the second equation, 1/6 x minus 5/6 y equals 11/16. It'd probably be just fine, but I think in the interest of time and everything else, I use the first equation. Now, I'm going to replace y with the answer we found, negative 3/4. Now I'm going to put 3/4 in here where y used to be. I'm going to use red, so the color red, so it's clearer for you and for me. I'm going to use the minus here because I have positive 1/2 times a negative 3/4. It's going to be minus this next answer. So minus 3/8 equals a negative 1/4. Now, I'm close to being finished, but I have some fractions to deal with now. Some people here are freaking out. I'm sure. Not a big deal. Fractions are our friends. Fractions are numbers. They're not crazy things that were invented. They're just numbers. So negative 3/8. I need to add 3/8 of both sides to move that to get rid of that. So I'll have 1/3 x equals something. It'll be negative 1/4 plus 3/8. Now, I could have used my calculator to get the answer, but I want to show how you would work with the fractions by hand. It's really not that bad once you need to know how to do that. You need the denominators to match. We have 1/4 and 3/8. Now, the 1/4 can be moved can become eighths if you multiply it by 2/2, and then we can work with the fractions together. We're gonna hold here for a minute. Now, you can see that I multiplied negative 1/4 by 2/2. The reason I can do that is because 2/2 equals 1. I have not changed the value of negative 1/4. I've changed how it looks. So you look at negative 1/4, it's equivalent to negative 2/8. Now I have negative 2/8 plus positive 3/8. I can combine those fractions because they have like denominators. Okay, now when you like denominators, you can add the numerators together. So negative 2 plus 3 becomes 1. Now I have 1/3 x equals 1/8. Again, we still have fractions. It's okay, but it's not a problem. We'll divide each one by 1/3. Now, watch what happens with fractions once you divide fractions by fractions. Wait a minute. Excuse me, I made a mistake on the y term. It's supposed to be x. I'm gonna repair that. Hang on 1 second, please. So now, that's why I say, use a pencil for your homework and for your tests. I have a digital pencil, quote unquote, and I can fix my mistakes. No harm done. Now you can see we have x equals 3/8 and y equals negative 3/4. But the fraction component here, 1/8 divided by 1/3. You can't do that. You need to multiply by the reciprocal. It's 1/8 times 3 over 1. You use the reciprocal and multiply through. And that becomes 3/8. X equals 3/8, positive, and y equals a negative 3/4. I would recommend that you check my answers. You can use a calculator or by hand. It's doable. Thank you.